大家好，我是宋婉媛，又见面了。上一次当我们说到茶的时候，有观众朋友提醒我们了，茶在北方跟南方可是很不一样的，究竟是怎么回事呢？我们请来了另外一位网络红人，来自南安普顿的 Joe。 Hi Joe, welcome.
Hi, thanks for having me. Word for the evening meal, the third meal of the day, is quite different. So down south we would call that meal dinner, but up north they tend to call it tea.
只是茶吗？没有食物上的不一样吗？
So another word, for bread. So a bread roll, down south we would just refer to that as a bread roll. But the further north you go, the more the word can change. So people might refer to it as a cob or a muffin or even a tea cake. And a tea cake, that can mean a little chocolate biscuit with some marshmallow on. So a northerner could be quite disappointed if you hand them a chocolate biscuit when they ask for a tea cake because they mean a bread roll.
你是从南方来的，那你有没有和北方人有过什么误解呢？
When a friend of mine said she needed to go to the shops to buy some pants, she meant trousers. So I was a bit shocked initially. I was like, why are you telling me you're buying underwear? Because pants down south would mean underwear. But up north, obviously not everywhere up north, but they refer to trousers as pants, just like Americans might.
My youth. 如果我是一个外国人的话，我怎么样才能知道我到底是在什么时候应该用南方的英语，什么时候应该用北方的英语呢？
A very quick and easy way to distinguish a northerner from a southerner is listening to the A vowel sound in words such as class. So down south we'll say class.
Class.
But up north they'd say class.
Class.
We would say bath.
Bath.
But they would say bath.
Bath.那就是如果这个啊非常长的话，那它就是南方，如果是啊，那就是北方。我们今天非常荣幸的请来了 Joe， 我们真的很希望下次还能见到他，让他再来给我们分享一些南北方英语的小差异。 Thank you very much for coming.
No worries, thanks for having me.